should he consider certain aspects of knowledge esoteric and other aspects as exoteric? The answer to this practically involves the realization that some knowledge truth is the subjective side of life, and the other type of knowledge with the objective side, that one type of knowledge is concerned with energy and force sense, the anger of undue hasty revelation, and another with that which is energized. Therefore it will be apparent that until the faculty of ascertaining the objective information is achieved, whole ranges of facts will remain outside the scope of the consciousness of the majority. As we have been told, the goal of evolution is the attainment of consciousness on all planes, owing to the small evolutionary attainment of the race only the physical plane is yet in any way brought under conscious control. The knowledge which deals with that plane. 16. In the sacred doctrine we are told that there are 7 branches of knowledge mentioned in the Puranas. S.D.I. 192. Correspondences can here be worked out in connection with A. The 7 rays, the lords of sacrifice, love and knowledge, B. The 7 states of consciousness, C. The 7 states of matter or plane, D. The 7 types of sources, E. The 7 initiations and many other subjects. The Gnosis, the hidden knowledge, is the 7th principle. The 6 schools of Indian philosophy are the 6 principles. S.D.I. 299. These 6 schools are A. The school of logic, proof of right perception. B. The atomic school, system of particulars, elements, alchemy and chemistry. C. The Sankhya school, system of numbers. The materialistic school, the theory of the 7 states of matter or prakriti. D. The school of yoga, union, the rule of daily life. Mysticism. E. The school of ceremonial ritual, worship of the devas or religion, gods. F. The Vedanta school, has to do with non-duality, deals with the relation of Atma and man to the logos. The Gnosis or hidden knowledge is the same as Atma Vidya, or theosophy, and includes the other 6. 286 ATREATISE on cosmic fire. Objectivity, the sum total of facts connected with the 5 lower subplanes of the physical plane are from the above standpoint considered exoteric. During the next 2 races the other 2 subplanes will be mastered, and the entire mass of knowledge concerned with physical and etheric matter, with energy, form and experience on the physical plane, and knowledge of the life evolving through the forms will for a considerably longer time be considered esoteric, as also will the apprehension and comprehension of the matter aspect, and the laws governing energy on the astral and the mental planes. This is stated in connection with average man, the rank and file of humanity. Objective or exoteric information is largely that obtained or ascertained by men in the hall of learning by means of the 5 senses, and by experiment. Experiment in due course of time and after many cycles of incarnation is transmuted into experience, and this produces eventually that we can call instinct, or the habitual reaction of some type of consciousness to a given set of circumstances or of environment. These 2 factors of the senses and of experimental contact can be seen working out in the animal and human kingdoms. The difference between the two exists in the ability of the man consciously to remember, apprehend, anticipate, and utilize the fruits of past experience, and thus influence the present and prepare for the future. He employs the physical brain for this purpose. Likewise, has an instinctual memory, apprehension, and an embryo anticipation. The clocking mind is unable to adjust them to circumstances in the sense of an arrangement, and lacks the capacity consciously to utilize, and thus reap, the benefit of past events, and to learn from experience in the manner which a man does.
Center of us.